So if you're watching this video or you're subscribed to my channel, you probably do so because you're interested in learning more about how music works. And I'm sure there's a lot of reasons why you'd be interested in that, but I think most of you are here because you want to level up your composition and arrangement skills. For those who've never done it, composition can be kind of daunting. So here are 5 tips for beginning composers. Number 1. You don't need to know music theory to start composing. This may seem a little weird coming from a YouTube channel that's all about music theory, but the truth of the matter is that you don't have to know music theory to compose. Some of the world's most famous, most well-known composers know little more than the basics. A little while ago, I interviewed anime composer Yamazo. Yamazo is a brilliant composer. He's worked on some of the top anime in the past couple of years. He told me that he doesn't really know much beyond the basics of music theory. So what I'm saying is you don't need to know music theory to start composing. Just start somewhere and just start writing. Number 2. Learn as much music theory as you can. I know I just said you don't need to know music theory to start composing. I used to compose without knowing hardly any theory at all, and now I still compose having learned some of that stuff, and I would not trade that knowledge for anything. I think without that knowledge, you're kind of writing in the dark. Music theory really helps bring everything into the light, and you can see what you're doing, and it makes more sense. The composing process will go quicker. You'll make more informed decisions. So music theory is a wonderful asset as a composer. I think every composer needs to learn it. So even if you don't know music theory, go ahead and start composing, but do your best to learn as you go. Number 3, listen to as much music as you can. And I mean music of all genres. Video game music is especially great about this because so much goes into video game soundtracks. Even if you have a specific niche genre that you tend to compose in, that doesn't mean that you won't find awesome techniques in other genres that you may want to incorporate into the music you're making now. The more music you listen to, the more you'll have to pull from when looking for inspiration. Number 4, transcribe. I can't tell you how much transcribing music has done for me. Transcribing is when you listen to a song and you write down the notes, whether that's just the melody or you're writing down every part or something like that. It's essentially like reverse engineering a song. If you can write down the notes and pick it apart, you'll learn so much just through that. You'll learn practical examples of music theory that you already know, and you'll stumble across lots of stuff that you never knew before. The entire reason I know anything about music theory or why I can play guitar at all is because I listened to songs, figured them out by ear, and applied that knowledge to either guitar playing or composing. And as a result, I've learned so much that I never would have learned otherwise. Transcription does require a basic knowledge of reading music. And if you don't know how to read music, I suggest going to musictheory.net, and they have a great course that's really clear and concise, which tells you exactly how to read music. And that's a very good tool if you want to get into that. Basically, if there's one thing you take away from this video, transcribe, because it will help you in ways that you never thought was possible. Number 5, failure is okay. Music is a subjective thing, and because of that, it can be hard to criticize your own work. A lot of creatives, and especially musicians, can find it very easy to hate the work that they produce. Even a lot of seasoned professionals can't stand to listen to their own work. So it's okay if you write something and you just feel bad about it, all right? What you need to do is write as much as you can and send that work to people who will constructively criticize it, especially people who know what they're doing or people who have composed longer than you have, and get their feedback on it. And just remember, over time, you will begin to develop an ear for what is well-written and what isn't. So if you're an aspiring composer and you're hesitant to kind of get into it, just start composing. Even if you don't know anything about music theory, just start writing. Learn as you go, and again, I cannot stress the importance of transcribing. It's really, really helpful, and you will not regret doing it. If you already dabble in composition, let me know in the comments, what was it like getting started, and what tips do you have to offer to newbie composers? That's all for this week. If you have any questions, you can let me know in the comments or email me at ongakuconcept@gmail.com. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next week.